Hi guys, I'd like to talk today about shining. And to shine you need some light, right? So Jesus said that He is the light to the world. You know, so if we have Him, He also said walk in the light. So our objection is, our object is to walk in the light daily. He is the light. So we have to every day deny ourselves, search Him, humble ourselves, have His light in us because He gives us through our prayers to Him. And walk in His light, in His Holy Spirit, in Him. You know, He leads us to all truth and salvation. Otherwise, we walk after our flesh into sins and eventually into death if we don't repent. So, but His light has a certain quality, you know, it shines. You know, if you have Him, He shines through you. The more you have Him, the more He shines through you. Another place Jesus said that out of abundance of the heart mouth speaketh. So, if you're not bold to testify about Jesus, think about it. Is He truly in your heart? How much of Him is it there in your heart? You're not wholeheartedly after Him. Read the Old Testament, some of the books of Old Testament. They show how there were kings who kind of followed God, but not wholeheartedly. And their end was very bitter and bad. God requires your full heart, your full commitment. You know, I know it's hard, I know it's not easy. Why it's hard? Because we are proud and our self is proud. That's why we have to pray to God to give us this discipline to learn how to deny ourselves daily and how to humble ourselves daily and how to have this discipline to seek Him daily in prayer and just tear our hearts open for Him and feel and just ask Him to come and feel us, you know, and walk after Him. Then He is with us. You know, just imagine what impact would we make if every Christian, true Christian right now, sat on YouTube and just recorded videos. Can you imagine what would happen? I think if this had happened, such revival would have happened. But you know, I know that not all people kind of feel comfortable of doing this. Some people are just beginning Christians, you know, and of course you got to do what Lord's called you to do, what Lord's calling you to do, but you have to seek Him daily and to ask Him, Lord, what can I do for you today? What needs to be done? Because He's your Lord. We're His servants. Jesus gives the parables of servants who used the given talents to them and they multiplied them, and there was other servant, lazy servant, who buried his talent, and then the Lord wasn't pleased with him, and he didn't let him into the kingdom of God, but cast him out, you know, to death and to hell, I guess, or to outer darkness, which is, I don't know if it's the same, but it's hell, it's not heaven. So, what we got to understand, Jesus Christ is Lord, which it means we have to obey Him. You know, those guys who evangelize, just believe in Jesus, it's not true, it's believe and obey, and you obey because you believe, and you see, God knows our age, you know, He knows how much He has given to the church of this age, you know, and there are many opportunities, and to whom much is given, much is tested. He knows what He gave us in Middle Ages or in beginning of the centuries AD. There was no internet, there were no printing services where you can print flyers and just hand them out or just put them in mailboxes of your neighbors or some people around you. You know, there was no emails, there wasn't anything like this, you know. There were no video cameras. Just imagine what technology is available right now, and we have to take advantage of it. You know, if you don't feel comfortable just getting on the camera and the witnessing, I suggest you have a discipline of daily praying to the Lord and asking Him what He wants you to do. He knows, don't be afraid, He knows your capabilities. He will give you stuff, you know, maybe he'll tell you to start with something simple, you know, just start with witnessing to people on Facebook or just for instance, I receive spam, lots of spam, like people trying to sell stuff, a lot of spam with porno and vice stuff, and just I was sitting there and thinking, Lord, well, this devil is wicked, you know, he sends this, his people send this spam with this vice links, and people just anybody receives these links and they open it and they get seduced, fall into sin, and fall into Satan's trap, you know. And I felt upset, I felt this devil is really, you know, really too bold in this century. The filth has never been so aggressive, you know. And then I had the thought, well, if the filth is so aggressive, so is the light, because there is same opportunities for the light to shine. And you know what? I decided, I prayed about it, and I kind of felt that to some of the messages, I just prepared the witnessing letter. I just saved it as a file, and every time now I receive, not every time, but a lot of times when I receive spam, I just copy-paste from that witnessing file and answer the spammers back, you know. Of course, some spammers are robots, they're not live people, but a lot of spammers are real people, you know, and they get witnessed to, you know. And Jesus called us to witness not only to our brethren, not just to witness, but to help our brethren and to help each other in truth and help each other understand stuff, but anyway we should direct each other to Jesus, but all our directions should be to brethren concerning how to get our relationships with the Lord stronger. We shouldn't lead brethren to ourselves and say, oh, listen to me, I'm guru. No, we should be leading our brethren to the Lord and just tell them how to walk with the Lord, how to seek Him, how to be humble in front of Him, how to seek Him daily and no man, just Him. You know, we're just consultants, I just can consult you, but I will never be your teacher, because there's only one teacher, who is Christ Jesus. But to the world we should also witness, that's our main goal. Jesus said, go into all nations and preach the gospel and baptize them in the name of Father, Son and Holy Spirit. And some people think, okay, unless I can baptize people, it's no use. No, it is. Maybe you witness, then Lord, through some other servant, preaches to him, then through some other servant, he will baptize him. It's the magnificent work of the Lord, and you just participate in some cycle of it, you know. Just, we got to start the revival, guys. I'm not calling you to carnal ministry, I'm calling you to really follow in the Holy Spirit, and Holy Spirit is alive, and God has His kingdom and His plans. And I'm telling you that if you pray to Lord and seriously and ask Him, Lord, please let me know what do you want me to do for you, when and how to do it, He will either tell you this or you will feel it by the guidance of the Holy Spirit. You will be moved and drawn to what you should be doing, you know. It may be witnessing live, and it's always witnessing live, plus it can be internet, or it can be a YouTube or Facebook, or just emails, or just printing flyers and passing them around, putting them in mailboxes. I don't want you to do carnal ministry. I don't want you just to elaborate some scheme and every day you just repeat the scheme. I ask you to daily pray to Lord and help you and ask Him to fill you with the Holy Spirit and submit to the Holy Spirit. And then Lord will guide you, you know. It's not what He told you yesterday may be different for today, but if you stay in touch with Him, you know, He will guide you. He wants us to be active. There is no, and you know, we are servants, and then Jesus Christ makes us His sons and daughters, because He prepared the kingdom for us. But in this life we have to serve Him. He's our master and Lord, and He has His plans, He has His kingdom. And if we are a lazy servant who thinks, oh, I'm shy of Jesus Christ and you know, and not doing anything, then Lord will be shy to say before angels and Father your name, you know. So now we shouldn't be shy. or if you're shy, start with small and see how it goes. But I'm telling you, when you work for the Lord, He gives you joy, He gives you Holy Spirit. If you're faithful with that little which you got, He will expand your gifts, He will give you more. And just don't sit there. We're not just called to have a personal relationship with God. We have to have personal relationship with God and then shine to others. That's our mission. Because if we love God, we have to love His people and witness to them and don't let them perish. Help them get saved again to know the Lord. God bless you guys. Bye-bye.